Well, this is my first store in Philadelphia. It's a store on 3rd, just north of Market. And I sell everything for the home, from pottery, which is my first love and main skill set, to furniture, lighting, rugs, and pillows, everything you need to create a happy and chic home. Originally, I'm from southern New Jersey, in a town called Bridgeton, an hour outside of Philly. So Philly's always been my hometown. I've always wanted to come here with my business, and I was just waiting for the right space and the right time so I could come into Philly with a bang. Philadelphia is very groovy. I think there's, so all the groovy people in Philadelphia will be my customers, but I think my customers in general are people who are either young or young at heart, creative, fun, and design obsessed. In terms of the price point of my stuff, it ranges from extremely accessible. You can come out of here and get something really nifty for $12, or you can spend a few thousand on a big piece of furniture, but I work really hard to make things affordable. And I think Philadelphia has just a very desirable demographic of creative urban funsters. Philadelphia people are really nice. They really are. I can tell you, since I've been here, every single person who comes in brings me some delicious, scrumptious baked good. So I appreciate that. And I don't know, Philly, for me, it just feels like home. I think, first of all, a lot of the retailers that I love are already here. It's an amazing retail market. There's fantastic stores, and I would just encourage people to come join the fun. So I appreciate the pulse of the city, and I like to shop in stores that are in downtown, because I think when you're in the downtown of the city, you tend to get more creative stores. It's not where every cookie cutter national retailer is to be found. So I know I like to find stores where there's a real sense of the personality or the person behind them. And you know, even though we have, I guess this is my 13th store, so I guess I'm a chain. I certainly don't feel like a chain. You know, we're still like a very small band of people who pour ourselves into what we do and try to be creative. And I think that Center City is where creative people should congregate.